We're live in Gehenna, Texas, at the magnificent HELNL Stadium. Built by zillionaire owner, GM, and coach Scary Clones. He describes it as a Roman Coliseum theme park, slaughterhouse, art museum, and secret bordello all in one. Both teams hit the field ready to hit each other in this MFL matchup. The Tokyo Terminators take on the Malice Hellboys. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. The paddy wagons in the parking lots are full. The familiar scent of bodily fluids in the air. And the men's room is both flooding and on fire. And that means MFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzer along with Bricks and Bricks Jr.
Man, last week some mutant let out a lava blast in one of the stalls in the men's room. Place went up like an oil rig. Flames and explosions. Water shooting out of where the toilets were. I electrocuted myself using the electric hand dryer. I wish they had paper towels at least as an option.
And it's first and 10. And that's how you shock the monkey. Thunderclap. And it's first and 10. The offense is pretty much unstoppable when they use their beast boost injection. Close your eyes, Bricks. This is going to get ugly fast. And he breaks away. He did it. He scores. And with that amazing run, he bursts through the end zone for six. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. And that player has one speed. He's the bullet in the open. I'm going to say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Second down and 7. Left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Four yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and 6. You've got to catch that. Third down and 6. Talk about Butterfingers. He should have had that one. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. Oh, no good. Now that punter's going to find a cutoff, and he just lets that one go. He says, no thank you, and the defense downs it. It's first and 10. And he shuffled his feet so well on that play, he should go to lost wages and deal cards. First down. And it's first and 10. And this guy looks like Thor on a revenge bender, right? And that hit jars the ball loose, and it's a fumble. That's what happens when you hurdle and take a hard hit. It's a touchdown. Why is it that no one can score in this league without showboating? Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It's good. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And that's when it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice rim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And it's first and 10. One potato, two potato, three potato, four. The defense, well, that's a strange penalty called right there.
I'm starting to notice that this ref likes talking, and it don't make much sense.
No, but he's making a lot of dollars.
And this is a first and offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and forever. Normally that would be a first down, but he had a whole lot of ground to make up. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Bricks, they just made up a whole lot of field in a hurry with that pass play.
And I just made up a new name for a sandwich.
Third down and 5. They couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
I had a dog named Snags. He got hit by a car.
Boom! And it's first and 10. Gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. Second down and long. Stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Yeah.
should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers.
Straight through the uprights.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10. Should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8 right there.
Hey, anyone seen that Korean kid yet with my barbecue?
Last time I ordered Korean, I got Kim Jong-il.
And a hard run there picks up the first down. And it's first and 10. Slice its way through any defensive player trying to block it. And that is called for a first down. It's anyone's game at the end of quarter one. Before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and 10. Third down and forever. The receiver makes a grab for 5 yards. It might make more sense to punt here than attempt a field goal. This is way too long. It's good. Teams are lined up for the kickoff. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and 10. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down in a mile. That's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. It's first and 10. And that's a great 9-yard completion there.
Hey, it ain't great if you don't score or move the chains.
And that'll bring up second and one. They get their hands up and block the pass. And that'll bring up third and one. Talk about Butterfingers. He should have had that one. Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. No return on this punt. The defense will just down it.
I can't tell if he's smart or scared. Either way, the ball is down.
And it's first and ten. That's a gain of 10 yards. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner.
That was a nice piece of running, Ben. That's a first down.
And it's first and ten. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Second down and 10. And they stack the line, and he gets his bell rung for a yard. Third down and 9. Oh, this guy just loves punishing the defenders. That's a first down. And it's first and 10. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. The brutal hit. And we're at the 2-minute warning. Second down and 2.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first time out.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
And it's first and 10. And like a monkey trying to... And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least.
The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. And it's first and 10. Now the QB is dinking and dunking the defense to sleep. 1 yard on that pass. The quarterback just used his final timeout. Let's see what they come up with on the next play. Second down and 9. Hey, Bricks, they're going for 2 here. And he makes the grab and adds 2 points to their score.
Why didn't the skeleton dance at the rap club, Grim?
I don't know.
He had no body to dance with. That's a pretty good one.
Home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. And it's first and 10. Don't hear it coming. It'll knock you right on your ass. It's called a...
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Ah, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this pass for me.
Kind of reminds me of that painting of Dad from the turkey. Well, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and 10. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second down and 9. A nice run there for 8 yards. It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsanto Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. We're at the start of the third quarter in a nail biter. The teams line up for the second half kickoff. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. And that's how you run it, folks. Picks up 8 there. Second down and 2. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and 10. He is rolling thunder and pouring pain. It's a zap attack. Welcome to Fumbletown, USA. Population, this guy. Well, he should be more careful when he hurdles. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and 10. Thank you. for two. And that'll be second and eight to go. Try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. Just follow the bloody footprints to the new line. That's a first down. Yard gain there. That's a solid pickup.
I wish people would do solid pickups more often. I step in dog turds on my front porch every day.
And that'll be second down and four. Oh, the defense must have called a hot potato dirty trick. That'll wake you up and then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose.
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
First and two.
You can't keep a good mutant down.
And that'll be second down and four. Third down, and the punter is warming up. The quarterback has had enough and calls a murder ball dirty and into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Trying to tie this up with 2 points.
And if they don't, things are going to get weird and desperate on their sideline.
Hey, give them more credit. This guy's a bam, gutsy run for the conversion. Now, this reminds me of a lap dance I had by a skeleton once.
Oh, yeah, after the mayhem ball at that club 6 feet under. Yeah, my wife could smell the bone marrow on me when I got home. Big trouble.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and 10.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Second down and more than the QB would like. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. Another bullshit penalty. How long are these guys going to take this? Second down and a and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Hit. Third down and, well, good luck.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And he booted a high arcing rainbow. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of 3 returns. Let's go. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor. Finish him.
And it's first and 10. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Second down and 10. Oh, he just got crushed. We're tied up at the end of the third quarter. You can smell the excitement on the fans. I mean, literally, it is ripe in here. Man.
Junior, was that you?
Hey, throw me.
Boom! And it's first and 10. Holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. Second down and 6. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
Hey, you kill a ref. It's not murder if they have it coming, right? Take the hit. Do something about that ref, you pussies. I only mean you have it.
Second down and a lot. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. Third down and never gonna happen. And they'll line up for the punt here. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and 10. First and 10. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and 6. And a dirty trick. This play is usually good. A pickup of about 3 on that play. Third and 2. First down and 6. And he pulled out a chainsaw, and now he's slicing and dicing his... Oh, and that's what you call a killer one-hitter, folks.
I did a killer one-hitter once, and an ungrateful, undead Ryan Fest. I woke up with 3 guys blowing on my kneecap.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10. Keep the drive alive as he rifles it in there and picks up 7 yards. Second and 3. He might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies.
And the 2-minute warning sound.
Sounds like what, Grim?
Sounds like the asshole I'm living on.
And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. And they take their first timeout.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
The offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
I am so confused!
And they need a miracle play, and they're getting them. First down! First down. They use their 2nd timeout, but they are running out of time.
A bit pessimistic, don't you think so, Grim?
It's more about building tension, Bricks. That's all we do at this point. And drink this bourbon. Come on, give me that. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
You're done for talent.
And here comes the extra point attempt. It's good. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Yuck! That was not a kick you put on the resume. And it's first and ten. Quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and ten. And the defense holds that pass play to only 2 yards. And that'll be second and eight to go. Any field goals over 40 yards are difficult. He's going to really have to boom this one. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
The Hellboys are defeated today. They battled hard but didn't have enough to get it done.
They choked like a bunch of banana choking chimp chumps choking on a bag of chimp dicks.
Did you just say choking on a bag of chip dicks?
Yeah.
God, that was beautiful. Once again, the folks at EvilSN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so you...